Welcome back, sir. All systems for gaming will be prepared in a few seconds. For now, feel free to grab a cup of coffee and have a good day.
What's up, everybody? How's it going? That's not coffee, but it's coffee and gaming. I'm your host, the Appalachian American. This is a weird setup we got here because we're live on two Rumble channels at the same time, all right? We're live on our old Rumble channel so that we can direct people to the new Rumble channel. The Men's Room is the new Rumble channel. It's the place that you want to go. So hit that link. It's in the description. It's everywhere. And if you're watching on the Men's Room, cool. You're where you need to be. But if you're watching on the Red Pill Society 1776, that's our old jam. You want to go to the Men's Room. Not the bathroom. The place where we're at right here. Joining me as always is my good friend, the author, David Applegate.
I was wondering how long it'd take to catch it on what a Men's Room was.
I knew what the Men's Room was, but
well, yeah. Well, please, dear viewer, come over to join our new channel. I know there's a lot of channels named the Men's Room. I mean,
it's in the link. If you're watching on Red Pill Society, it's in the link right now. Yeah. Go over, click that link. It's in the chat. It's in the description. It's two different places. Please go there. Find the YouTube, or if you want to stay on the Rumble, you can stay on. You can hit the Rumble. It's actually the first. Let's see. Right, I'll take you through it. If you guys hit that one right there, let's see. Bam! All right, if you guys hit the link that's in the chat right now, if you're listening on David's stuff, you probably won't. You probably won't see the link anyway. But you can hit this Rumble. It'll take you straight to the Men's Room Rumble. If you still won't like YouTube, you can hit that. There's Instagram, there's Facebook. We have it all situated. It's all there. Just go over to the Men's Room. We will be live every Friday night, and we will be live almost every Saturday morning. We do some late night gaming stuff when we're recording for YouTube content, because YouTube is primarily the channel that we are trying to make money on. But with that being said, we'll make money anywhere we want, I guess. Ain't it right, David?
Well, according to many, and I'm not saying this lightly, but YouTube has stalled. There is a second apocalypse coming. They're talking about pretty much this is the problem. When YouTube first started, partnership programs were easy to get. And people were making money off channels with only 100 subs. Now, of course, YouTube thought, oh, scalability issues. Let's cut back super chats. Let's cut back partnership programs. Let's get rid of the merch links. Let's create a new joint. My problem with YouTube is they're like Facebook. They're attention deficit syndrome in a bag of nuts. They
yes.
have to keep changing everything every time. Every week something changes.
Right.
I have to constantly change something.
And the crazy thing is that we've had so many the Red Pill Society channel has gotten so big over the last year that we haven't even touched it. And it's like, man, all these people are like, I wish we could bring them over to the men's room. Like, I don't know how to do that. And then it hit me, hey, why don't I just set up an RTMP link, go live on both on like a Thursday night and see if I can direct the majority of 557 people we have on Red Pill over to our channel on Rumble with 159. So if you're watching now, which I see four people are on Rumble on the Red Pill and five people are over on the men's room, like go over to the men's room, hit that link in the description, go over to the men's room.
Yeah. We're talking to people right now on Rumble, on Red Pill Society. Back then, it was a backup channel. It was, we finished with YouTube, upload to Rumble.
Yeah, well, see, here's the thing. We started the men's room actually first, but it was primarily just pop culture and movies and stuff like that. And then it got to where it was like, well, we've started talking politics and we were afraid of YouTube. So we were like, let's make another YouTube channel. And we did a weekly show over on Red Pill for almost a solid year of every Tuesday night. And it got to the point where it was like, okay, now then the movie news turned into political talk. And so we were talking about similar things on Tuesday and Friday. And it was like, dude, this is not benefiting us at all.
No, we had so much overlap. Because,
so we were like, at that point we had gotten a whole bunch of strikes on YouTube, the Red Pill channel, and we were like, man, this just isn't beneficial. Like, we don't, you know, whatever.
So it's a backup.
Yeah, so we left it there, and we just started primarily talking on the men's room page, just like, you know what, forget it. Let's just go, and if we say something, luckily YouTube has not pulled us. But we do talk primarily politics on Rumble. So
yeah,
it's been nice.
And the problem with YouTube is that they had a good system. They changed it. And now it's changed again. And even their strike system has changed, where they're now primarily focused on not what we say, but any music. They're pretty much 99% going after people playing music.
Right.
Because YouTube's primary income, allegedly, is YouTube music.
Yep.
So they're focused on that. They don't care about us anymore. They don't care about the video channels anymore.
Right.
That's why there's no partnership programs been on offered. That's why there's no partnership sponsors or any prize competitions. Just a stupid blog saying the same three things over and over again. You want to grow more? Share your links. You want to grow more? Learn to use hashtags. But they don't tell you which hashtags.
Oh, of course they don't. They don't want you to. It's always a guessing game.
They don't want you to grow. They want us to bring people to YouTube so they can sell you YouTube music. That's it.
Yep.
And we get no revenue from that. So if you see those YouTube music links, you're not helping us out.
Yep. Hey, if you guys want to call in, the phone lines are open. 540-232-9476. Call us. Talk to us. I'm sorry. I'm using a text service because I don't want to give out my personal number. And so every 2 weeks or so, they have to give you a new phone number. So I was used to saying the original phone number, and then we had to change it up today. So you guys call in, feel free to talk to us. We're going to jump into some video games. We're going to chill out, talk about stuff. If you guys have anything to say, comment, you guys can dictate the conversation. If there's something that you guys want to talk about.
Yeah. Ask us questions. pretty knowledgeable on what's going on. We've seen the
David's the all knowing.
Yes, we've seen the projections for Indiana Jones, and quite frankly, it's going to be like The Flash. They say it's just like The Flash. The first half of the movie is competently made, competently written, and is entertaining. It's a 5 out of 10. That's the first half of the movie. Then, like The Flash, the second half is a 3 out of 10. It's two different movies in one. And I did a personal video ages ago when Dial of Destiny was announced, what, 3 years ago?
Yeah. That was a dumb
after they finished shooting, they brought out I forget her name. Who cares? They brought her out in a...
Are you talking about Phoebe Walrus?
Phoebe Walrus.
Biatch is what everybody calls her.
Yeah, Phoebe Walrus Biatch is in a, what is it, a tan, well, you know, one of those tan adventure suits, you know, from the safari suit from the 70s.
Yeah.
With a fedora. They brought out a Phoebe Hallbank Bridge doll in a fedora. And I remember the uproar. And I remember them pulling it, a special limited edition doll for the movie. And then they pulled the movie. They brought it back because they can't get a tax write-off on it, folks. That's it. That's the only reason why they're suffering it. I kid you not, Disney right now has an army of lawyers looking for IPs and tax write-offs and deductions everywhere. They want to cut $6 billion off their production budget. This is Disney Studios. Disney Theme Parks is carrying the load. It's making money. Disney is up 13%. You may be boycotting the movies, but you're still going to the theme parks and you're still buying all their merch. So
yeah,
Disney doesn't care. Yep. 13% increase in profit. And that's with $870 billion in write-downs on failed movie projects this year.
Yep.
They don't lose money. They just go to the tax man, hey, give us a break. Or the government, hey, give us a bailout. People forget when Disney sent Detroit broke. Remember the Detroit Movie Fund? How it was going to save Detroit. And what did Disney do? Hoover up every last cent, produce 10 movies, and then shut down for COVID. And Detroit, never going to get out of bankruptcy. China will hoover that up.
Yep. Man, there's 5 people watching over on Red Pill Society 1776. Hey, hit the link in the description. Come on over to the men's room. That's where we're going to be from now on. But yeah. Yeah, you guys can call in, talk to us, say hey. We do reserve the right to bounce you if you say something stupid. But other than that, if you're cool, we're cool. Can I help you, bro? All right there, Jesse Jackson. Are you just asking the questions? Because I'm just asking the questions. Yeah. Maybe you heard something because you saw something, dummy.
Do not try that at home, folks. Go ahead, big. We'll just pick you up, bend you over, and snap. Love video games. Power fantasies.
Oh, man.
Do you know your game's muted?
Is it?
Yeah.
See about game settings. I have some audio?
That's weird.
Do you hear that?
Nope. Do you?
What in tar? Yeah, here. What in tarnation?
Your audio's not being brought over.
Yeah, hang on. Hold your horses.
Yeah.
Oh, there it was. I must not have hit the button.
Share audio, yeah. That's fun.
Oh, gosh. I'm getting shot at.
You're not picking up the case? Or...
Come on, I want the case. Give me the case. They're not giving me the case. Oh, no.
What? You blocked in? That's the way you came in. How did this happen?
I'm gonna have to, 187 some cops here. I don't think you are. Send a gang after him.
Man. Oh, that was heavy.
Oh, that Lord.
Shit was gunfire.
We've got a patrol car in pursuit of suspect.
Took all of them.
No.
Why are the police looking for me?
We need to find this guy.
Suspect ain't nothing.
Well, there's cops out there and like...
They couldn't find me? You for serious, Clark?
Well, no, the assassins. They didn't find the assassins. Didn't
right.
The assassins.
God, we're gonna circle back and see if we can pick them up.
We're gonna circle back. Circle back. Oh, I hit the person, not the dog. That's good.
Copy that. A patrol car is en route to the suspect.
Give me your cars and your chopper. Give me your clothes and your chopper.
Get to the bike.
It's Pride Month. It's Pride Month, so we could ask for clothes and it not be too out of crazy.
It was in the gay bar, so it's a Pride Month.
That's hilarious.
Yep. But Anna's lost me the other day when he mocked Christians. That's it. You're done, honey. Thanks.
Yeah.
Showing your true colors. Yep.
Oh, yeah, for
built
sure.
Built your movie career on our backs. And now that you're retired, you told everybody what you think of your fans, and like, you asshole, I want my money back.
Yep. Didn't he call them all buttholes or something? Yep.
Delusional buttholes. Yes. The actually delusional buttholes. Heaven isn't real. Wake up. It's your delusional buttholes, he said. Yeah. What a coward. Right?
Yeah, dude, it's crazy.
What an absolute coward.
Right. Exactly.
But what Arnie has done is paved the way for Gen Z, millennials, and perhaps even maybe the alphas to actually stop believing in Hollywood stars, because you never know what they're going to say in the future. So he's really ruined a lot of people's careers.
Yeah.
Chris Pratt right. may not get AAA roles next year, but we don't know. After Mario,
Chris Pratt's cool, and we don't care.
No, but after Mario, I doubt that Sony is, Sony don't care what this Hollywood boycott is.
Four wheeling over the ferns.
But it's not just Chris Pratt. Do you know that Hollywood called for a boycott for those who were in the Miles Morales movie too?
Over the what movie?
Miles Morales, the, you know how they were, you know, the new Spider-Man?
Miles Morales, that's right.
It's Miles, Sony's next live-action Spider-Man may be called Miles Morales.
Because Miles Morales is Miles Morales.
Because he's
Peter Parker, Spider-Man.
Peter Parker, yeah. But yeah. for some reason, Hollywood has now got their butt in a twist, in you know, their panties in a twist over Chris Pratt and Sony, over nothing really. It's just they just don't like Chris Pratt for being a Christian, right?
Yep.
He hasn't said anything, and nope. now they want to extend the ban to all Sony products. And Naughty Dog is saying, "Oh, leave us out of this." And
yep. Just a reminder for everybody over on Red Pill Society 1776, we will probably not be going live over here often.
An investigation has been
if any,
to determine whether
we go to the men's room.
Along with former Congressman
Man, shut up, lady. I'm trying to talk about something. Hit the link in the description or the live chat right now, and it'll take you over to the men's room. You can either pick the Rumble or the YouTube. There's Twitter. There's Instagram. There's all kinds of cool stuff. So go over there, leave the Red Pill Society 1776 page behind. If you're watching on the men's room, well, congratulations, you're already there.
No, I think Miles Morales is just the working title they're doing for the live action. I think it's all part of an orchestrated effort by Disney to send other people broken, hoover them up, you know? Honestly, I think ESG is one big scam. A couple of companies take it on, make money, force the other companies to do it, and when they do it, they go broke, and then they just hoover up the companies for really cheap, right?
Yeah.
Because Disney thought they're too big to fail, too big to go broke, right? But their studios cannot run at a loss. Their shareholders look at it and say, well, I don't think it's just Disney Studios. I think Disney Plus is also losing money.
Yeah.
But everything else is making money.
Everything is losing money.
Yeah, well, don't forget they're making money now because they fired thousands of employees. They cut
yeah.
back on all these expenses. So that's where the money's coming from. Is all the payouts and all the properties they've sold. But all the investors see is 76 cents per share in their special dividend, so they're happy, even though they should be getting a dollar, over a dollar each. Oh.
Oh, you buttholes.
He's shooting the shotgun, so.
Yeah, but he shot my jumper.
Yeah, I saw that. Did you notice that when Karen talks, the gunshot stops? Karen is so loud, she can talk over a gun. There we go.
Time to take up the competition.
Just pull this.
I just cause a distraction, run in the back door, and take care of business. Now I'll run out this door.
Oh, wait.
No, what are you doing? Move.
Why are you running into the wall? I was going to say, why are you running into the wall?
Like, what are you doing? Go.
Butthole? Dingus.
I'm wearing like a bright neon blue suit, and it's like, whoa.
Where's the hacker? I don't know. Could it be that guy? Nah. What the heck? Oh, they're not shooting at you for a change.
Oh, yeah, they're shooting at other people. But I'm about to take his car, so I guess he's going to be not very happy. See ya. Wouldn't want to be ya. I took your car, fool. I crashed your car, fool. They are coming. That's cool. Send them. I don't care. I don't care what you say, fool.
Yeah. So they're finally getting that.
Two people watching over on Red Pill and five watching on Rumble. You guys should drop some chats wherever you're watching from so we can say hello to you.
You know, it's really weird. They're finally admitting that Cyberpunk has balancing issues. The 50% of players are going to get a hard game.
Why we play video games?
Yeah. Half people are getting a hard game and other people are getting an easy game.
God.
Suspects have been reported near your location.
We're on his tail.
Yep.
We have an alert on a possible felon near your location. Over.
On your knees now.
How did you see me? Man, you did not see me, bruh. Oh, yeah, God. Oh, my gosh. Oh, crap.
You had the USB.
I'm getting shot up because I'm driving in this tin can.
When you got into the car, the "you have been spotted" line appeared. I thought you saw it. White line to your left. Doesn't always show, though. Yeah, this game has issues.
Be advised, units are en route to the suspect's location.
Crap. Bro, what are you doing, dog? Bro, dude, come on, bro.
I love how in video games they portray cops as always shooting people first. And nobody raises an eyebrow. Yet in real life, if a cop defends himself, they're all over that shit. People are so stupid sometimes. Helicopter. Oh, in a valley. Here it comes. Drop the weapon, lie on the ground as we're shooting at you. You'll be lying on the ground soon.
I'm about to be lying on the ground here in just a second. Golly.
Oh, somebody just went heavy on you.
As a cop.
Did he just shotgun you from the other side? He just shotgunned you from the other mile away.
He got it. That butthole.
He tagged you.
Thanks a lot, Dead Sick. Whoever this dude is, man, thank you. Like, I'm live right now, and you're up here messing my game up. No, I don't want to team up. Leave me alone.
Leave now.
Can I help you, dog? Look at this dude's, like, bouncing this thing all around.
Whatever. He's tagged you.
Leave me alone.
He's tagged you.
Out now.
Go away. Leave me alone.
Yeah, you broke low sight. For some reason, breaking line of sight doesn't always work with the chopper, does it?
Well, I guess I'm... guess I'm just going to walk.
Oh,
there's a car. I'm going to take it.
I love how his phone can open cars.
Right? Oh my gosh, the dude's going to show up again.
Have you got a live person in your stream?
Yes.
No, I mean, he's live in our stream. He knows where you are.
I think so. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. Man, that's dedication to actually see. I can't see it. Must know who you are. Is that you, Jason?
No, he doesn't. Like, there's random people that show up.
Yeah,
and like they can like talk to you, and like you can communicate with. If I had a microphone on the,
no, I mean he could see where you are, and I'm thinking he's watching the stream.
Yeah, see, there he goes. He shows up again.
Yeah, he knows where you are.
Dude.
Whoa.
Not cool, bro. Not cool.
Oh. Hacking everything.
God.
He's watching the live stream so he can see where you are.
Oh, the dude just committed to the S word that you can't say on YouTube.
He exited stage left.
Yeah, he deleted himself.
Yeah, just can't say the actual meaning. Gotta use euthanisms for some reason. But unfortunately, there isn't exactly a hard rule list. The other day, a streamer got banned for saying fuck. And he says, I say fuck in my streams all the time. What do you mean? Is there a fuck limit? If so, what's the limit? Is it hard? Is it soft? But according to some streamers, you can't say it in the first 10 minutes, which is weird. Because advertisers only care about the first 10 minutes of your video. Which is weird, because if it's a popular video and the guy says fuck, the advertisers know he's going to say it. So
yeah.
Why do they care? I don't think it's the advertisers. I think it's the gatekeepers at YouTube. I don't think the advertisers even know. Because YouTube, well, I remember when YouTube hired a whole bunch of community managers and they pumped people's streams and they made people money and got people advertisers and got people sponsorships. But then came Google. They wanted that sweet billion for themselves. Now they're pumping $1 billion a year into it.
I don't know how you're supposed to get that.
Is there another side? No.
I don't know how you're supposed to go in there and get that.
Yeah, look at that. I think you're supposed to send the little jumping jack and jump through that hoop. It's whack, I tell you.
I don't know how you would get the jumping jack down in there.
Neither do I. But is it? Put it on the list of things that will never be fixed.
Yeah, that we'll come back for later. Now, what is this? This is under. Also,
did you get it?
Yeah, I wonder if I can go over here and zap it. Hey, what's up, LMP?
Hey, LMP.
Good evening, gents, or as I assume our resident Aussies is, he's probably, what, daytime right now?
11:40 a.m.
Nice.
Got it, David.
Yeah, it's the, what time is it now? It's like 9:40 p.m. over here in the States, specifically here in New York City,
yeah.
Which sucks. I cannot escape this hellhole that we call New York, gentlemen.
Well, it's probably pretty smoky there, ain't it?
Not like last time. Last time, all sorts of jokes and memes can be made about it. This time, maybe a little bit of like that smoky smell in the air. But compared to what happened last time, where the sky was a yellow, the sun was red, and all sorts of jokes were made. Yeah, not the same. Not even close. Hey, who knows? Maybe I'll wake up tomorrow morning and I start coughing out smog or something.
It's even affecting us. Like, we're having problems down here.
Yeah, man. What is it? Where is it this time the fire took place?
They say Canada.
Damn, I can I say Canadians in this chat?
Yeah, I don't care.
We're damn not Canadians. Yeah, I just don't want to get the stream pulled, you know. It's not my live stream. Okay, good.
It will be on YouTube at one point in time.
Okay. Well, still, I don't want to get the video pulled because I said damn Canadians.
No, that ain't, I don't think that's going to... I mean, I'm pretty sure YouTube even thinks that.
I think you'll upset Justin Trudeau. That's about it.
We don't care about him.
Did you just assume Justine's gender?
Yep.
I assume he's a lady.
Because he's gay. But it's okay because it's Pride Month.
He's God. A lady. I bear witness to some weird things last year and then this past Sunday when I was just going.
Yeah, like what?
There are just certain things you should never see another human being wear.
Oh yeah.
Micro guy in a micro. What's it called? You know the Borat swimsuit.
Oh no, that was tame.
I know, right?
That was tame.
Yes, I saw the Pride Parade yesterday in New York. I saw what they weren't wearing.
Thank God I was nowhere near there. I was not anywhere near there. But the thing was, you go on the subways, you saw all sorts of things. And I was like, all right, listen. You can call this a culture. You can call this anything you want. Spin it any way, which way you want. But in a less tolerable world, this would not be tolerated. This would have ended.
LMP, if they do it, if they write books with certain actions in it, they get a free pass because it's Merrick Garland's daughter's boyfriend. But when I do it, I could go to jail. If I did it, sorry, I would go to jail.
Oh, no. That's clear as day. Yeah. If any
they are breaking the law, it's just the law's not enforced. What
can I get you? Oh, trust me. It's really screwed up, gentlemen, because it's to your point. It's a double standard, right? It's like a certain other double standard I'm not going to get into. Because, again, I don't want to, rock the boat too much either. It's not my stream. A certain other double standard involving one of two genders that tends to be a little privileged than the other. If they do a certain action, it is seen as empowering. But if the other one does it, that's jail time. I think you can figure out the rest from there.
Well, yes, women started it with their gender identity politics, and now they're
time again.
Hey, Tommy's fault.
Tommy's fault. When did you change my pronouns? Are red and neck.
Oh, dude, that was like a long time ago.
Oh, wow.
My pronouns are emperor.
It was a couple weeks ago when those kids got. There was like it was something about it was something about these kids were like having some kind of. It was right at the beginning of Pride Month because they were like, "Oh, you need to learn about pronouns," and them kids were like, "My pronouns are US and A."
Oh yeah.
Yes. Oh yeah, that was good.
Yeah, I remember that. One kid.
Didn't the teacher flip her shit or something like that?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
One kid. It started with one kid was asked his pronouns, and like he's only 6 years old. He said, "Kiss my ass."
Honestly,
So the rest of the class was making up new ways to upset the teacher with pronouns.
Good.
Because the boy said, "My daddy says his pronouns are kiss my ass and God bless the USA." And like, you can imagine the blue head's response.
Oh, yeah, didn't she lose her shit? Like, think like go into panic mode or something like that. I read.
Oh yeah, for real. Yeah.
It's like, goddamn, these people really are mentally ill. It's not even an edge. An edge just means you're crazy, but mentally ill is like, as soon as somebody says one thing, you just completely go off the rails. Like, do you need to take your Xanax? You need to take your medication? Because you probably need to upgrade that prescription a bit for some goddamn tolerance.
Bro, did you hear about the state representative, Kiana Carr?
I'm sorry. What did you just say?
A state representative keyed somebody's car because it said Biden sucks. And he keyed their car. And the cops caught him, and he was caught on camera. Okay. And he said the guy threatened me, so I keyed his car.
I got the details.
The guy wasn't even in the car. The guy didn't see me until he was already keying it. And it's...
Wow.
He said that I think that's one of them crazy gun owners.
Hold on. Can I tell you what you actually meant? Can I tell you the story? Because I just looked it up. Okay. A Rhode Island Republican Party chairman called for a state senator's resignation after he was arrested for keying a car with Biden sucks bumper sticker. Surveillance footage showed Joshua Miller, 69, keying the car in the Garden City center of Rhode Island, according to police.
Oh, this happened in Rhode Island? I thought it was happening in...
It was a state senator from...
Yeah, state senator.
Fucking Rhode Island.
And but yeah, he keyed a Republican's car for having the bumper sticker. Yeah. Hide it sucks.
That's hilarious. He does suck.
But the guy was like, I didn't key his car, and the cop goes, the keys are still in your hand. Like,
I have you on tape, sir. I have you on tape.
Like, it was hilarious. He denied it, and then he goes, well, I thought he was stalking me.
Right.
Right. Like, as if he would be worth stalking.
The guy's like, I don't even know who he is.
Oh, look. He made it. It's the I always make it about me crowd, right?
Yeah.
It's always, listen, these representatives, these politicians are getting worse and worse. Like, once we, what was it, one that was like, twerking in like a whole bathing suit and everything. What was it, last year? I think it was.
Yeah.
Kamala Harris.
Oh God! No. Listen, Barf. I'm pretty sure. In her younger years, she probably was a looker. People, those days no longer exist. So anybody who was thinking that, you are really got some low standards.
Yeah. This is no lie. I was on a VR chat. And they were talking about Nancy Pelosi, and it was a liberal. And they're like, well, she's got big chest. We'll go with that. We'll make it PG-13.
I was wondering what you were going to say.
And they was like, I would do it. And I was like, nah, dude, come on now.
Okay.
That is wrong.
They could have left that as just as an observation. They didn't need to go full, like, oh, I would do it. Like, come on, dude.
Yeah.
Nancy, you went out and got a boob job? And Paul picked up a trans activist. So, Nancy, I think getting a good job was a waste of money.
If you don't I mean, she's still doing, I mean, she's still a speaker, so who knows if that
no,
would be.
She's not.
No, she's not.
She's retired.
Oh, thank God. Damn, I've been under a rock this whole time.
She hasn't been speaker for a hot minute.
It's Speaker McCarthy.
LP, for God's sake.
God, I really got to go out and touch grass more.
You might be a speaker when she's speaking to her lawyers.
Yeah.
Did you think Nancy got real ugly?
Probably.
Probably. Man, you got to be ugly when you're mistaken for Kevin McCarthy.
Oh,
oh God.
That is real ugly.
You know what?
Actually, listen, Nancy, that would be the improvement.
All I can say is, if she used the state-funded money to make enhancements, to steal a line from a show I once watched, What's the point of putting new headlights on a totaled car?
I like that one. Well, that's like Kamala. I ain't looking at her face when she's on her knees.
Oh, God. I don't want to do it. I don't want to say it. I don't want to say it. That's the
deep. I kind of want you to say it.
I'm out.
I outdid myself.
Just say it, LMP.
I said it. That's the default position. I just walked away.
Yeah, oh, default God. Position. It comes to Kamala, that's the default position.
Has she even been on the news lately? I haven't seen nothing about Kamala.
She was at a...
I'm sure they have because Biden got impeached today.
Yeah. Mm. Well, yesterday Kamala was giving a speech to a bunch of high school students and she says, "Girls, you're the future of abortion." And then she started laughing. The entire room was just deadpan. Because I think they realized that, wait a minute, you want us to kill our kids? I mean, you want a mum to kill the kids? I mean, you don't tell a bunch of kids, hey, it's a shame your mums didn't get an abortion, but it's not too late for you girls. And it's like, wow, that is just like psychotic.
Okay, backtrack a second, Kamala, with that. You're saying that it's too bad their moms didn't get an abortion, so they're the future and they should get an abortion. Did you understand what you just said? Of course not.
Yeah. Of course, she knows. She's absolutely psychotic. Please, you just
yeah. But most of the girls that follow her are stupid enough that they probably should get one.
This is my point. You just said that your mom should have aborted all of you growing up, but before any of you had this graduation, your mom should have aborted all these girls that are graduating today. Like, yeah.
It's a shame your mom didn't get an abortion, but it's not too late for you. Yeah.
Listen, I've said to people, I'm not going to act like I'm a saint, right? And I'm far from it, gentlemen. I will get downright evil sometimes. And I've said that to people as insults. You walk an abortion or anything like that. Okay, great.
What
I just
incarnation did I walk into?
Right? But come on, in no way in shape or form could she not realize what she just said there to all that room full of girls.
It's like Kamala, you support euthanasia. We'll go get one.
Hey, can you throw a grenade down and just watch him?
What?
Also, what the hell did you just walk into?
That's what I just asked. Like, what in tarnation?
Oh, God, no. I've seen this before.
I do have music cut off because that way. Hold on.
I've seen this before.
Because the music is only licensed for the game, yeah? not the streamer.
It's a self-deletion cult.
It's the Whisperer.
It's one of those cults where they're going to delete themselves.
Heaven's Gate?
Yeah.
Where they all look like...
Now the music is on.
A drunk Paul Rand.
Well, that one guy in the background is really killing it with those pelvic thrusts.
So a lot of people's talking about Trump and... What is his name? He was on the Joe Rogan show. I can't think of his name right now.
RFK.
Yeah.
Robert Kennedy.
Them two running together.
Yeah, I heard that. Trump said no.
Different parties, ain't they?
No. Lincoln ran with a Democrat. It's not unprecedented. And of course, you know what happened to Lincoln after he ran with a Democrat?
I don't want to say it.
I don't want to say it.
Accidents happen.
JFK haircut.
JFK haircut.
Didn't somebody put it?
I stole that from some other YouTuber.
Hang on. There was a movie review one time. I think it was for Captain Marvel. And somebody said from A. Lincoln said it was the best time I've had in a movie theater in a long time. Oh my God, I know, right?
Jesus.
The most fun I've had in the theater in a long time is what that said. That was so funny.
Bravo. Bravo. That was a that, yes. It's been a while since I think I've heard a very good Lincoln joke. Bravo, whoever came up with that.
That was a good review.
Well, talk about mind blowing. Oh man.
Little comedy club gold there.
So what else is good, gentlemen?
I'm doing parkour right now.
Well, CNN put out a poll that Joe Biden got a 48% approval rating, and they just said it's his highest ever.
Also, Joe Biden uses a ball gag.
Oh, I saw it.
I am not surprised.
Yes. Yeah, the White House put out a press statement saying that due to respiratory issues, the president is using a CPAP machine.
Okay, my only thing is about
that. Oh, crap, I died.
I think he's on oxygen. And I really, and this is the reason why I say that. He was in a full suit and still had the markings on his face. Has any of y'all ever, like,
felt No. When you first get a CPAP machine, that happens because you get seal mouth.
In the mornings, when I wake up, I have lines.
Okay, but how long does it last?
Usually, it goes. Usually, you stop having a reaction after about a week. You do see the lines sometimes, but you can.
No. I mean, it's pressure. They're pressure marks. So I mean, you know, they're on there for probably I don't know half hour or so.
Yeah, just throw them away.
If you let's say you fell asleep with it, could you get in a suit, dressed, and everything, and still
he's probably on.
And getting off a plane at that.
No. If he's going on a plane and if you are prescribed a CPAP machine, I had a neighbor who was I'm on a CPAP as well. But my
I use
neighbor,
one every night.
Whenever they fly, even in a helicopter, they have to use oxygen because their blood oxygen is that low. Mine's not too bad, but some people do get prescribed oxygen as well.
See, I think it's an oxygen tank.
Yeah, but that's probably when he flies. That's normal with somebody on CPAP. Low blood oxygen.
Which is fine, but they don't want to tell the public, hey, he's on oxygen when he flies, because they don't want
But it's not a big deal. People half his age get on CPAP machines for apnea and low blood oxygen.
I mean, I'm 34. I've had one for about a year and a half.
Yeah, it's 30 of his age then. Yeah, it's a disorder that people don't have much explanation
for. How's the air quality affecting you, Seth?
What do you mean?
With all the fogginess and everything from it coming from Canada.
I mean, it's fine. Same as normal. I mean... It doesn't sleep apnea. Doesn't I mean? I don't know.
No, I'm not
like
talking about sleep apnea. I'm talking about where it's the smoke's coming down. Is it bothering your allergies? Yeah. Is it affecting you any?
I'm getting like headaches and stuff.
Yeah, my daughter got it. She has asthma though, but she's getting a headache. But it didn't seem like it was making her wheeze.
LMP, did you ever fix your smoke detector? Or are you still chirping in the background?
Chirping. I removed that thing a long time ago. If you hear another chirp, that's a different.
I heard a smoke detector.
Could be somewhere on the other.
Dude, how do you deal with that?
I know it's not mine because mine's directly wired to the house.
Nah. If anything, I had the batteries replaced on these, so I don't know. Could be a different floor too. You know, it's not like I live in just one family place or something.
I hear the chirp. Chip.
Yeah, did you hear it just now?
It's a chip. I got a bird.
Oh, no, wait, are you talking about like that boop sound?
Yeah.
Yeah, that, I'm getting notification messages from Messenger while on this chat.
Oh, right. That's what I thought, because it's pretty regular to be
a regular
chirp.
It would have been like chirp, chirp every other minute if that was the case.
Yeah. Okay. Do we want to keep the taco truck?
I say, how do you feel?
If CNN wanted some actual, like, horrible people talking, just sounds, they should go play video games. Because them kids at 13 have got a mouth on them.
Yeah, I know. Some they actually banned the streamer the other way for excessive use of the F word.
Gosh.
Somebody messaged me again, but I muted my notifications, so.
Be right back, guys.
All right. Take your big old truck, buddy. I do what I want. Oh my god, he's shooting at me. You wanna die today, fool?
Well, it looks like the Ahsoka film is going ahead with $350 million budget. Kathleen Kennedy put out an announcement that Lucasfilm has finally moved past George Lucas and they're leaving the past and they're letting go of the past. Reboot. Anybody smell a reboot?
Yep.
Well, yep. Like I said, the films may be failing, but the Muppets are buying enough toys to keep them in business.
No kidding. Remember when The Mandalorian came out? I knew at least like 7 or 8 people that were buying the stupid baby Yoda shit.
Yeah.
Most stupidest. I want to use the R word so badly on the stream, but I can't. That's what I think of that stupid character.
Rancid?
Yeah, let's go with that because I can't say what I'm going to say.
Eric Adams or Bill de Blasio.
Don't get me started on that one. Apparently he lost his cool, and I think he compared a white woman that had some words for him. It says she was a plantation owner or something like that.
Shut up, Cowan.
there is not one moment that guy does not bring up his race. Like Christ, dude.
That's the whole point. 70 years of whining.
Well, yeah. What do you guys think about the affirmative action thing? Supreme Court.
Racism. I hope it goes
through. Well, yeah, but I mean, like, I heard that there's, like, riots and stuff now because people are pissed off.
Yeah, didn't they basically rule against affirmative action now? Like, it's no longer a thing?
Yes, because it goes against equal justice.
Yes. I misunderstood what it was about at first. I actually had to watch a Styx video about it. I was like, oh. So they finally got rid of that bullshit?
No. All they've done is declare it's illegal. The states won't ratify it.
Yes. It's so we're back to the whole abortion argument, basically, where it's not a ban. It's really up to the states to determine what the hell they want to do with it.
Yes. Because they can't. Because the courts don't have any enforcement. So it doesn't matter. Now, if you saw that I posted a video on Facebook, that explains the origins of both European fascism, Yahtzeeism, and socialism all come from the same movement. And then what is a neocon? And you'll understand how they're all connected. The uni party is bigger than you think, and its origins are deep within French society, even today. Everybody keeps calling the English the puppet masters. They're not. they themselves are the puppets.
Speaking of trucks, well, watching trucks. Seth, when are you going to start back on your truck?
I don't know, man. I need to. Well, I need to sell my motorcycle.
Well, we need to put it together.
If I can sell my bike, I can put all that money into the truck.
When are you going to put the motorcycle back together?
I don't know. Tommy, you got too many questions, and I don't have the answers.
Yeah, but when I have his weekend, sometimes your gears start turning, and I start seeing.
Yeah. Well, let's see.
I know.
Let's see. First, he had the sub guy come. Then he had work. Then he had some adulting to do with the family.
Well, see.
Then he had the chicken coop.
When we were younger, about 10 years or so ago, I used to ride in his truck. He, and his hauler is a windy ass road. Like, it's windy. But
Tommy, you better not be saying something that's gonna get me in trouble. Cause you do know my mom's always on here.
I'm not saying nothing. I'm saying for
she already suspects. Ford truck,
it handled that road very well.
Your mom's gonna appear any minute now and say, "I knew it."
At 35 miles an hour.
At 35
miles an
hour. 35
miles an hour. Yeah.
It was fun riding in that truck, even though I'm a Ford fan.
Yeah, it's a cool truck. I got stuck in my truck. I wasn't in it that night.
The carport.
Oh yeah, yeah. You're right. You're right. Yeah, Tommy, man, that was something else, dude. I cannot believe you drove up underneath the carport and got stuck.
Yeah. It squatted.
But yeah, it did. And it about lifted that yep. About lifted the garage up.
Yep.
So what my game plan is for the truck is like I wanna sell my bike. I think that'd be cool. And I've already got permission, which, like, I guess I need to ask permission, you know. The wife's already said any money I make off my bike can go right back into my truck because she doesn't want me riding motorcycles anymore because everybody and her brother keeps dying, which I really kind of agree with.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to... what I'm gonna do is once Brandy's car gets paid for, I'm gonna put money into buying me a new truck, not a new truck, but a truck.
Yeah.
And then
you're gonna LS swap the other one.
Well, I'm gonna take the Tahoe and rip the guts out of it and put it in the S10.
Oh.
The 5.3.
Yeah.
It's pretty much a 327.
So are you going to rip everything out or are you going to get the computer flashed?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm just going to do a standalone ECU.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
You got to find some headers to put on it.
Yeah, because I've got to find a I got to find a certain type of header for it. The more of them we drag into the light,
the more torches and pitchforks we're going to see in response. You got to switch the old man too, don't you?
I don't know.
Well, no, man. But the people are angry, and they should.
Well, no, because there's not. I'm thinking of a four-wheel drive Chevy. You should be fine.
Right. The headers, the way that the steering link, steering column and everything is, I have to find headers that go around the steering column.
Shit. When was this decided? Man, we did rock, scissors, and dynamite.
Yeah, but I wasn't even there.
No, but if it was a tie, you win. Wrench did paper, I did dynamite.
My dad used to make them. He says it's a pain to make them yourself.
Warehouse. Now he's got the delicate job of reading the fucking manual. Then you are going to go to the front door, get the model numbers, and send back to him for the default codes. I will be nearby looking at blueprints and power plans.
Yo, let's do it.
All right,
yeah. What are you playing? I know it's Grand Theft Auto, but I never saw this.
It's Watch Dogs.
Oh, it's Watch Dogs. I thought it was Grand Theft Auto.
No, just it's Watch Dogs, too.
Not been playing Halo. I mean, Grand Theft Auto.
We played Grand Theft Auto like a couple weeks ago.
Yeah. Now, who makes Watch Dogs?
Ubisoft.
Because it has a lot of similarities to it.
Yeah.
Like the open world concept. Now they got a city and then they got a countryside too, don't they?
Yeah. Well, it's pretty much California. Because right up here is the Golden Gate Bridge. So it's pretty much San Francisco. There's Oakland, San Francisco, and Marin.
Well, Pixar's still paying more than Sony. Jeez, Walt Disney, the average wage at Walt Disney is only $35,000. And their corporate revenue is $82 billion.
Oh, Jesus.
And they've shrunk their employees by 223,000 this month. Far out.
Bud Light's giving away their beer free again.
Oh, two dates, sorry. I was going to say.
Well, I don't like gay.
Yeah.
I don't like gay beer, so. That's right up your alley, Tommy.
I'll admit, I used to drink Bud Light. I like Bud Light, but I haven't drunk it since they went gay.
Yeah, what was...
Really, what have you been drinking?
I haven't drunk no beer.
Wow.
I had...
Well, that's good.
I had a thing of Bud Light Platinum in the fridge. And it just sat there. Until it's time to throw it away, and that was it.
My turn.
Wow.
Junior's in. I need to figure out where I'm taking
it. You're looking for the security hub nearby. Blueprints show it's EMP protected by a Faraday cage. So it's not going to work unless you stick JR all the way in there. That did sound kind of dirty.
We can get through this.
You're mad.
Ah! Hold on to something.
puzzles.
Ah.
Environmental puzzle.
Why are you doing this to me?
Is he complaining about being remoted? Why have a remote if you're going to complain?
Keep heading toward the loading base. The security room is just off to one side.
Look for a switch box. There's got to be one somewhere.
There we go. Love it, Doc. I've actually seen puzzle sorting rooms, and they are pretty much like this. They're ridiculous.
Junior's in place. Everybody say night-night to Junior.
Night-night. He detonated an EMP.
Inside the security bot, yeah. Please, everybody out there, do not do this to Google or Facebook or Twitter.
You had doubt? Yes, please, do not.
Yeah. When, well, Ranch picked up Titus's default door code. Although with the antitrust lawsuits going on, I think that's why Paige and they're selling out. You know, oh, Alphabet. Oh, we transferred all the capital assets to Alphabet. And, oh, Google gets taken down. Oh, too bad. So sad. This feels like when someone called a fire alarm in high school. All right, try to breathe even. Long breaths in. Out. Yeah, it'd be so sad if Zuckerberg lost $78 billion. Not. It's all phony money anyway.
So, David, what kind of car do you drive?
I don't have a car. And I used to have a Hyundai. After it broke down, I just couldn't afford another car since. I didn't want to become one of those trash monkeys, you know, save up $5,000, buy a trash car, you drive it around for 6 to 12 months and then, you know, have it sit in your yard until it gets hauled away and then save up another $5,000. Though some of these trash cars only last 3 months.
Yeah.
And if I got a car, I have a 13-year-old son. So what do you think?
Yeah.
Maybe. Dad! Dad! He's driving his mother crazy. Wanting to be driven around.
You don't got a car, so when you want to go somewhere, do you take the train or?
I've got a train to the city. Yeah, if I want to go to the cinema, I've got a train to the city, and if I need to go to the doctor, I've got a bus. It goes straight, sort of there. Goes to Chermside, then I take most of our shopping centres are bus hubs. So I go from one shopping centre to another, then to my destination.
The EMP worked like a charm, right?
Yep. Call me.
So when's the last time you drove a car? I'm curious.
2 years.
2 years? Oh, I couldn't last 2 years without driving. I enjoy it too much.
Thanks.
Could you go 2 years without driving?
The problem is I could get a road scooter, but you can't take that on the highway. And there are too many highways around here.
Mm.
I mean, if you want to go anywhere decent, yeah. But I mean, I'm within walking distance of a shopping center, train station. Most of the time, my doctor just does conference video calls anyway. But I still have to go in once a year for a checkup. So they're talking about making those every 3 months.
So I take it you've never. Have you ever rode in something lifted?
Wait, what, sir?
Have you ever driven like a truck that's lifted or anything like that?
I've been in a truck a few times, but when I was like 18 and I've driven a forklift a few times when I was working at the hardware store. But that was, I think the. A truck was a seabed.
Got
a target? Yeah. It's an open 5-tonner. And it's different, I tell you. You got to guess. You got to know the size, you know?
Yeah.
And it's different because the weight, even just tapping the accelerator, you know, you just roll it and it's like, and it's stopping. You know, even at a snail's pace, nothing stops. It just doesn't stop straight away, you know?
See, I've drove dirt bikes and mini bikes and even scooters and everything, well, mopeds. Yeah. But I've never gotten on a motorcycle yet.
I haven't been on a motorcycle, but I've been on a mini bike, you know, one of those small ones.
Yeah,
and they are just the same as a truck, you know. They don't you just touch the accelerator, they take off. Just touch the brake, but the difference between them and the truck is when you touch the brakes, you pretty much go boink. They're just too light.
I saw someone on a bike yesterday. They were too short for the bike, and like their feet just even. While they're riding, they can have their feet straight down and it's not touching the road.
My first ex, she never used the brakes. She would just let go of the accelerator and gear down. She was just that quick on the gears. She'd driven a moped for like, yeah, since like 12 or something, you know. So she was never used the brakes. Not once. She geared it all the time.
Do they do drag racing up in Australia?
Yeah, we got a track west of here. I haven't been in a long time. It's freaking expensive now. But they have now and again they have a youth program where they try to get offenders to learn to drive properly on a track, you know.
Yeah. All right, I'm on my way to the server room.
You should be able to walk right up to the database server now. Except for all the alarms,
lasers,
guys with guns.
Oh, that easy, huh? Thanks.
Yeah, we're mostly peaceful activists. Living the California dream, gunning down security guards. Wife and family? Ha! Who cares? We are activists. It's justified because corporations are evil. Simply take drugs, just pay for our health care and feed us and pay our rent and subscribe to our OnlyFans. Child support. So what if I got three baby daddies and I don't know which one's which?
Headshot.
So with your S10, are you gonna put new? You're gonna have to get new tires for it, ain't you?
Probably. They're pretty old.
What are you gonna get?
I don't know.
Some Mickey Thompsons.
Possibly.
Oh, we've got a guy in there. Oh, had.
Now your windows ain't tinted, are they?
Yeah.
Yeah, they are. Yeah. I'm thinking about tinting mine, but I don't know how dark I can go.
It varies by state, doesn't it?
Yeah. Varies by state and if they actually enforce it or not. Some have, like, they have laws on the books about tint, but they never check it.
Yeah, most of the glass we have out here has a 5% tint. And most tint, see, that's the problem. A lot of people, they get tinted glass for the sides because you can get the sides done, but you can't get the front and back. You can't change them. So it looks really looks cool from the side. Then when you see it from the front, it's like really weird. Ooh. Is it on the other side of that one? Oh, there it is. Terminal.
Now I gotta hide.
All right, Greg, send it something you wear.
Oh, yeah.
That's definitely something. You know, this is going to take some time to parse. You should be close to a private lift in the CEO's office. My blueprint doesn't show where it goes, which means it's exactly what we're looking for.
Stay calm. We have you on CTOS. Police will be there shortly.
I lost it!
You didn't lose me because you never had me.
Track him down.
Damn, will you look at this place? She even got her own private elevator.
Of course. Don't want the miserable peons to see how well dressed you are and how happy you are that they're miserable.
Right.
That's what cameras are for. Oh, somebody's happy in aisle three. Go get him. Send the supervisor.
Looks like Todd is some kind of prototype lab.
Right, yeah.
Let's see what they're keeping in sub level six.
LMP's going to like, take a switch to work, hide under the desk, and play all day.
Wait, what happened?
I said, you got the right formula, haven't you? Take a switch to work and hide under the desk, and if anybody wants to talk to you, you start asking about the state of New York subways.
Oh, God.
That way they just leave you alone. You can play Switch, hide under the desk and play Switch all day. Nobody wants to talk to you.
Like, how did I get myself into this? Like, who did I piss off today to make this happen?
Oh, you know me, I'm an asshole.
Of course.
I don't need a reason.
Oh, yeah, he made a woman cry like the other day on Anime Night stream.
Okay. That I want to know more about, because all I remember was you guys said something about me and that I should go on. But by the time I like saw the text and I was finishing my game and I got to it, all I did was I got on. I clicked the link, listened to the stream for about 5 minutes. And it was something about her dying cat. And I'm like, then why are you doing the stream?
Okay. First, she was going on about something about how both parties are the same. I said, no, they're not, but I'm not going to argue with you. And she says, I'm trying to make my point. You never let me finish. Like, and then.
Yeah, dude.
So we just sat there for like 5 minutes and she said nothing. We had nobody talking, nothing happening. And so I start talking.
She kept trying to make a point, but she wasn't making a point.
Yeah, she just wants somebody to argue with. So no, nothing was said for almost 5 minutes. Absolute dead air. And we're talking about music, and then she starts rambling in the chat that nobody's listening to her, and nobody wants her around, and all this. And then she comes back crying about a dead cat. Well, dying cat, dead cat now.
I mean, whatever, like cats, whatever. Who cares?
Yeah, I knew a cat had cancer, and she said she wasn't showing up because the cat got cancer. Cats get cancer. I'm sorry.
Yes.
Cat cancer is not curable.
Domestic security situations, these new models will easily be able to withstand small projectiles.
So all I heard was something about her dead cat, and then the worst part was I started listening to the point where she was going on, like, I don't know. The best way I could describe it, she sounded like she was moping about something. And, okay.
Yeah, that they're her friends. That outsiders are coming in. Well, Anime Night invited a whole bunch of other people too. It wasn't just me. And she was going off at about her husband not being there for her. But he's got it work.
Oh, my God, is all I got to say. Are you for real?
Yeah. And Fire X, he was just like, I think he's made friends with Anime recently and he was invited to the stream. And like, all he wants to talk about is metal music. He don't care about some of these cats. Not my cat.
Oh, Okay, I mean, the next thing I remember listening was that one of the guys, as she was crying, I don't know who the simp was, but then he started saying something about it reminds me of when my grandma died. I'm like, okay, very odd.
A person dying and an animal dying is two different things.
No, I think the stream had too many people on it, and she has to make
it. Trying to white knight it?
That's what I got from it. That's what I got from it.
Guys.
And I was like, I'm sorry. Guys, if you're going to white knight, can we at least look for... Okay, guys, please. I'm not saying... I understand the white knighting. It's in our DNA. Guys like to protect females. That's just evolutionary.
That's what they do. Wiring. Yeah, evolutionary wiring, yeah.
But please, for the love of God, can we at least pick a hot one?
Dude, for real.
For Christ's sakes, man. We what the hell, man? You have higher standards, please. At least, okay, I'm not saying treat the ugly ones any better. I'm not saying she was ugly. I'm just saying. Don't treat the ugly ones any worse. What I'm just trying to say is, if you're going to white knight, can you at least go my lady for somebody that, I don't know, just a little more easier on the eyes? I'm pretty sure I just got this. I'm pretty sure somewhere. Some feminist ears just like went up. It's like some guys talking about like only pretty women should be defended. I'm not saying that because sometimes pretty women should not be defended. They know what they're doing.
But should you white knight they're already in a relationship too? Because it's not technically your own responsibility if they're in a relationship.
Like at least if you're going to do that, can we have some better standards on the white knighting? Like, no, all women, I think this is like the old cliche that all women are beautiful on the inside. I'm like, well, yes. And if you see anything of how they look on the outside, inside probably is far worse.
But at the same time, it's like she said her cat's down. It's like, you could easily say, well, when I was 7, my goldfish died. Like,
it just sounded so awful. I immediately backed out of that video. I was like, okay. I told you guys, I was like, what the fuck did I just listen to? Sure enough, I could not tell a friend of mine about what happened because he was nearby, and he's like, "What's got you so mad?" So I told him like what I just heard, and he just gave me this look on his head, on his face, like, "All right, man, I don't know who your friends talk to, but I'm backing away right now." And we left it at that, but God, man, and it's probably a good thing I didn't like. If you had it put me on a conversation like that, and he started on some shit, I think at some point I would have made her like rage quit that whole stream.
So was she sympathy chasing, like just trying to get attention? Is that like a villain of it?
Yeah, she wanted to. She's controlling, manipulative, and I think right now she's trying to insulate her position by getting rid of the newcomers.
Yeah, she makes his chats not, or his stream's not fun.
It makes it about her because and her art and her photography and all the shitty things going on. And he's trying to talk about anime and trying to fill us in on a whole bunch of anime stuff.
Knock the fuck out of the prototype while I work at the door.
I mean, we can't have any more good anime channels or any good anime discussions anymore without someone trying to be a spurg and in the actual chat.
Well, the problem is just some of the other anime guys, they want to make it about furries, they want to make it about heavy metal, and that's the problem. The problem is Anime Night races through some of the shows. He should be doing a show on each instead of trying to cover bits and pieces. So. But then he says, oh, this is a hangout stream, and I get it. Because he does do his reviews on separate. And I love this robot, man. Where can I get one?
I do too. I'm feeling I want it.
I know some guys in the other game who want one. how do we port this to the other game, folks? That's the sequel.
So, Seth, when are you, what are you doing for the 4th?
Hold on, man. I'm having a hard time hearing you because there's so much gunfire.
Oh.
What? Gun guy brewer. Heavy metal.
All right,
All I heard was heavy metal and anime.
Yeah.
Hey, gun,
what gun, are gun. What are you doing the fourth, sir?
I think we've got a family reunion, but I'm not sure.
Is now open. There should be an elevator. You'll need to find your way up to the backup server room on sublevel 3.
Who needs elevators?
Make sure you smash the shit out of everything.
So let me ask something, Dave, since I'm kind of curious about that stream you've had. What was the whole purpose of it? Like, what were you guys discussing anyways about anime? Or was it just
he was trying to catch us up on the anime that was coming out this week.
Okay.
And for some reason, right as I clicked in, while I was waiting in the lobby, my water boiled, so I come back, and then she was just going on about how both parties are the same. So something happened, and I'm not going back to try and find it, but she keeps trying to make it about politics.
I mean, I'll bite. Okay. If there's a political discussion to be had about anime, I can buy that, because in 2023, there's a lot of shenanigans happening with Japan, with the U.S., especially with who's trying to dictate when in anime, corporate takeovers. It's a big-ass rabbit hole, right? It's a very deep rabbit hole right now. And I'll bite in that regard. But honestly, it's like, if it was just the general anime chat, just don't even bother at that point going that far. Like, I honestly think she knew. I mean, like, I'm more than convinced she knew what she was talking about. I'm more than convinced that he was just saying that to kind of like get the attention on her and focus. She probably wasn't expecting someone to take something back, which is probably why she started bitching in the first place. Because, you know, she's probably used to, hey, I'm going to say whatever I want. And because I'm a chick, nobody's going to challenge me on it. But then, you know, she forgot the number one rule that certain Aussie don't dare. And that's what happened. That's what I'm getting from everything you're telling me. And then, honestly, I walked in. I mean, I listened in at the worst time. And all I gathered from that, I'm like, if your cat is dying or your cat is dead or whatever, why are you screaming? Just take the time for yourself. Don't be bitching about what's wrong with you and your life. And then me having to hear a guy talk about his dead grandma. I'm like, come on. This is an anime discussion. You guys just brought the mood down entirely. I could care less what led up to this. You guys are just total spurts.
Good luck. All right, Tommy, you were asking me a question about something, but I couldn't hear you over all the gunfire.
I was just talking about the fourth.
Oh, what's going on the fourth?
Nothing for us. I was just seeing what everybody else was doing.
That's crazy. Y'all ain't doing nothing for the fourth.
I don't know. It used to be the big time of the year.
Yeah.
Do you know Disney has a studio that makes billions of dollars and nobody knows about it?
No.
Yeah. You know that, you know how the saying about the largest, you know that direct-to-video about how direct-to-video is making billions of dollars in US right now with selling Pornhub?
Huh.
They're like, you know, it's like YouTube for porn. Hundreds of videos a day are being produced. Well, it's owned by Disney. Away from pride eyes. DeathSec
Pride and what we found should worry you. So if I do not hear from you or see you today, you and your wife, happy anniversary.
Oh, thanks, man. I mean, we'll be live tomorrow.
Yeah.
You do not exercise your right to test now. We will build an army to keep you quiet and compliant.
Venice is partnered with Bloom to grant CTOS access to their machines. Yeah, great. Big plan for
just dinner.
Should this project continue, we will not stand idle while that happens. DeathSec has given you the truth.
Do what you will. Join us. We're DeathSec.
Get all the 5 million videos currently. Later. From 50,000.
There's three
studios.
People watching over on Red Pill Society. Please hit the link in the description. and go over to the men's room. Please, please and thank you. To the three people over on the men's room Rumble page, you're there. Yay. And to everybody on David's social media, thanks for coming.
We've got some really bad news. Can you come in?
What's going on?
Some bad Marcus, news.
You're all over the news. Homeland Security just put you on their most wanted list.
The fuck?
Better come to ground, amigo.
Oh my gosh.
Just music, Disney theaters. Yeah, I knew about that. Equity stakes. Yeah, lots of company. The ABC Group. Yeah, FX Networks. Disney Interactive. I thought Disney Interactive was shut down. Oh, they're still on the name. Okay. Shelf companies, yeah. God, they've got a lot of equity stakes, A&E Network, yeah. And the Hearst Corporation. Yeah. A&E, yeah. Disney owns some TVs, yeah. Through ABC, yeah.
What a shame. They invested so much in the presentation. Another one of Bloom's Silicon Valley romances just died.
Aw. You can't see it, but I just shed a little tear. Seriously, though, we killed a 10-year investment and probably Bloom's big chance to further tie law enforcement to the CTOS with their... whatever the fuck they were doing.
Look at this little noodle core. Tank police.
I refuse to admit that was a real proposal.
Totally real.
That's hilarious.
CTOS is monitoring the situation. Police are on route.
Oh, keep laughing. The Google Drive is Google's trying to corner the rideshare market. They don't know what they're doing, but they keep talking about it. But I haven't seen a Google car in a long time. But apparently, they're trying to come up with a business model for you just walk up to a car, tap the scan the barcode with the QR code with your phone, and the car unlocks, and apparently you need a Pixar 3 to do it and testing it out.
I did hear about that.
Yeah, you drive the car around and then you leave it and it shows up on the phone app as available whenever you lock the car. So I can imagine you go on shopping, you lock the car, go inside, the shopping center, you come out and it's gone.
He could probably reserve it, but here's the thing. What if you get carjacked?
Well, the thing is, you've got to have insurance. That's the thing that's stopping.
I was reading a story. There's a big thing going on with them scooters where you put money in. And people
steal.
Yeah, and then you're getting charged for each mile that they ride it.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. They're saying that these cars, they have a key code, and the unlock. Once a hacker gets the unlock code, that's it. You know, they're gonna locate that car. Wait for somebody to use it, and then they're going to come up and use the unlock code on it and drive off. And it's still on your dime. Sure, you can reserve it, but you can't lock the car. That's the problem. It's got an unlocking code. And once enough people know that unlocking code, you're gonna have a whole industry of carjacking and joyriding, where people go to joyride.com and look up a car and go, yeah, there's one near me. I got my day code. This is my 0 day code. I'll go jack that car. And because of all these Karens screaming about to please don't chase the kids, they're just having fun, or they're not harming anybody. Again, proper explanation into their mentality, yes.
Oh, look, there's even a smaller car. I must drive it. Give me your one-seater car. It like won't even hold traction. One hit took both doors off, or at least one, and a hood. That's crazy.
Wait, what? Wait, go back to the side. Yeah. Why is it not showing the door? Oh, that is.
Because it broke off.
No, the other door. It looked like it wasn't showing the other door from the inside.
Donuts. Nitrous donuts, yeah. Tie me up and show him that that one real fun place that we go and just spend like 20 minutes. You know what I'm talking about?
One road.
That one road.
You know where it is.
This is going to be the funnest thing you've ever seen in your life. You will die laughing.
Is the car going to make it?
No. We'll see. Probably not. But we got like 2,700 meters to go. So we're balling. Hopefully it'll blow up. Cause that'd be funny. Oh, wrong turn. Oh well.
Have you seen the new cars that actually project arrows on the windshield?
No.
Yeah. It's gonna be coming out in 2024 or 2025.
That's a thing though?
Yeah, it's going to project it onto the windshield, so like you type in your GPS and it tells you where to turn on the windshield. And they'll have
I lost both doors. Oh, guys, man. Don't forget, if you guys are watching out there on social media, you can call 540-232-9476. I'm still trying to learn that number. We have a call-in number. And I prank called Tommy with it earlier.
Yeah.
And it was funny. This poor rattle trap. Hit a tree. Mini road trip.
Did y'all see that? All right.
We made it.
Remember, it's Pride Month. Take a knee. Look in the chat. They said take a knee for Pride Month. I just take a knee.
Hey.
What is that, Shane? Shane to Body Media? What? I don't get it.
Oh, man.
Center Body Media, that's the company Disney acquired that's making the most of their most of their money right now.
So, all right, Tommy, watch this. Porn
in the United States, the largest producer of gay porn.
Oh, crap. Wrong button. All right, ready? Watch.
But LNP, did you see it? Take a knee for Pride Month? Yep, you saw it. Under the knee.
Tommy.
I'm watching.
Tommy.
Yeah, y'all did this last time y'all played this, y'all were doing it on the stream.
Oh, you've seen this?
Yeah.
Man, this cracks me up every time.
Oh, you got it on the side. Oh, you fucked it back.
What the hell are you doing to that car? I mean, to that truck? Oh,
so
okay.
There's these rods, the ram, like the barricade rods.
Yeah, yeah. I see it now.
Yeah.
God, wouldn't that cause the car at some point? Like, wouldn't that happen to the truck at some point?
Yes, it would break the frame at some point. It's hitting so hard, it would break the frame.
Yeah.
I'm sure something.
And these are big trucks. These are big trucks to be bouncing like this.
Oh, my God. This does look like fun.
Will the tires eventually pop?
Huh?
Will the tires eventually pop?
Maybe.
Because slamming down like that, that...
Oh, yeah, dude. There's so much weight on that semi, man. It's ridiculous.
God. He has it too much.
He's like Mario.
Okay. I got to get... You know what? Sometimes Triple A gets it right. Triple A gets it. It's always the things that they don't intend you to do that are the fun.
No.
Kill somebody?
Probably.
Hey guys, instead of me going to save the instead of me saving the village from Ganon, I decided I'm gonna turn on all of you. Yeah, I decided to be an asshole. I'm gonna start killing the villagers. What do you mean I can't do that? Next thing you know, one Game Shark code later. Well, okay, see, now I'm showing my age by mentioning Game Shark.
Game Sharks.
God, I am old now. Very hard reality to face. But yeah, gents, I am going to call it a night. I am going to be up early, and I just got to do the last few minute things before I go to bed. So it's been fun. Probably join next time if I have a chance. Not... till next time, gentlemen, and if I don't talk to some of y'all,
have a good fourth. Oh, God, did you see the motorcycle? Did you see the motorcycle?
I had to contain my laughter. Oh, my God. So I was trying to talk.
I am sorry, man, like, but almost, that was like, too funny. Words out.
That was too funny.
That was really funny.
Oh, my God, what the hell did you just do?
David, did you see that?
Yeah, I saw it exploded. He's just standing there like.
No, the motorcycle did like 8 backflips.
Yeah, I saw it.
You should really try to flip a person that stands on top of that.
Oh, language, buddy.
God.
Oh, that is hilarious.
That is hilarious.
God, dude, that bike went flying.
This is probably like the most fun I'm watching this whole stream.
I know.
The barricade.
Oh, there is.
Oh, I got it. He's upright.
He's upright.
Oh, boom!
Oh, he's back on his feet.
He's freaking out, but yeah.
I'm done. This is hilarious. All right, gents. Y'all have a good night.
All right, dude. Yeah, we're getting ready to end it.
SCOTUS, you cannot court order. You cannot base college admissions on race anymore.
DedSec was released earlier today. DedSec revealed footage taken from inside the top secret facility that showed the technology being prepped to deal with rioters. The hackers released information that military technology company Titus has been redirecting taxpayer dollars in their research funding to build militarized robots that would be used in domestic policing. So far, there has been no comment from Titus.
Oh, Lord. All right.
What the heck happened? Oh, no. Couple of threads got deleted on Facebook. Okay.
All right. Let's see. All right, guys. Last time I'll say this. Get off of Red Pill Society and go over to the men's room. Link is in the chat and the description. So please click that link, go on over, and you'll see us over there. There's 7 people watching on Red Pill Society. Click the link and go over. We don't go live on this channel. This is an old channel. We realized that it gained some traction. We don't use this. We use the new one. We use the new channel. So go over and click the men's room. That's our new channel. We go live every Friday. Every Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern. And then coffee and gaming is usually Saturday morning. So yeah, go over there and check it out. It's gonna be a good time. That being said, buy David's book. Because he wants it. He wants everybody to buy 8,000 copies. So, join us tomorrow.
Subs, that's 7,999.
Yeah. Buy David's book. Check us out tomorrow, 9 p.m. over on the men's room. If you're watching this on YouTube, if we made it this far on YouTube without getting pulled down after everything getting said, then woohoo. But this won't be on YouTube for a while because I think I've got a couple more in front of it. So anywho, we'll talk to y'all later. We'll see you. Bye.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye bye.
Good day, sir.
Later, dudes.
Good night, Jimbo.
Hell, I got to go.
Peace out.
Burn in hell, New World Order. Fuck you. Fuck you, New World Order. Fuck you, Bill Gates.
I love you.
You gotta do better than that.
I love you.